गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू यूपी राष्ट्रीय टंडन ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी. माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर दिनेश कुमार गुप्ता, स्कूल ऑफ साइंस. टुडे वी डिस्कस UGCHE 101 इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, बेसिक इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, यूनिट 3 केमिकल बॉन्डिंग, मॉड्यूल 4. In this unit, we have studied module 1, module 2, module 3, and today we discuss module 4, that is weak interactions, hydrogen bonding, metallic bonding. Okay, let's we start with module 4. Hydrogen bonding compounds and functionalities containing hydrogen atom attached to electronegative element. Hydrogen atom attached to electronegative atom or element with at least one lone pair, often associating through hydrogen bonds. We see EH bond. It is electronegative element and hydrogen bond between an electronegative element E and hydrogen is highly polarized. It is highly polar bond EH, and the partially positive charged H atom can interact with an lone pair on the E atom of another molecule, forming bridge that known as hydrogen bond. Although hydrogen bond are usually much weaker than conventional bond, their collectively action is responsible for stabilizing complex structure such as open network structure of ice. Similarly, solid HF consists of chain structure that survive particularly even in the vapor form. This is the FH bond, and this hydrogen become positive and this become negative, and this bond is hydrogen bond. And further, this H is slightly positive and this it is slightly positive, like this. It's denoted by delta. Okay. And then further hydrogen bond takes place. Look the structure further, where the hydrogen bond, these all are hydrogen bondings. Next, they are also responsible for recognition between specific, they are responsible for recognition between specific DNA bases, adenine, thymine, A and T, and guanine and cytosine that underline gene replication. AT double bond, GC triple bond. Ammonia, water, hydrogen, fluoride all have much higher boiling points than other similar molecules. Shrinking evidence
for the hydrogen bonding is provided by the trend in the normal bonding between points, which are usually high for the strongly hydrogen bond molecule like water, in which there are OHO bond and ammonia containing NHN bond and hydrogen bond containing FHF bonds. The relatively low boiling point of phosphine PS3, S2S, HCl and the heavier P block molecule hydrides, molecular hydrides, indicate that these molecules do not form strong hydrogen bonds. Here, like water, this is this, like this tetrahedral structure in water or ice bond takes place. This figure showing boiling points of hydrogen compounds. Boiling points of hydrogen compounds, like you see 100 degree centigrade for S2, HF, N3 and methane. Here, where in these three, all hydrogen bonds takes place and below they do not form hydrogen bonds and this form covalent bond. Due to this hydrogen bonds, the boiling point of hydrogen compound is higher than usual other hydrogen compounds. Water has other usual property because hydrogen bonding. How? For example, freezing point of water is much higher than that of similar molecules. And even more shrinking feature is decreasing in density as water freezes. Water freezes, the density increases. Density decreases. Tetrahedral structure around the oxygen atom with two rectangular bonds to hydrogen and two hydrogen bonds to molecule required a very open structure with a large space between ice molecule. This type of structure it is tetrahedral structure for hydrogen, where hydrogen is here, 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 in between this, and this forms a cavity between molecule. This makes solid less dense than the more random liquid water surrounding it. So ice floats. That's why ice floats. Life on the earth would be very different if this were not so. Lake, river, ocean would freeze from the bottom up. Ice cube would shrink. Ice fishing would be impossible. In this figure, it is the ice, this is the water molecule, and this is the hydrogen bonds. This is the hydrogen bonds. and this is the, and this form a tetrahedral structure of oxygen. This, like this, you see, this is the we see in this figure here. This is peptide carbonyl groups and this is protonic alpha helix of peptide carbonyls, NH hydrogen bond adjacent turns to helix hydrogen bonded. Here all hydrogen link with hydrogen bonds and this hydrogen bond link between all hydrogen bonds. See, oxygen and hydrogen bonded with hydrogen bonds. Due to hydrogen bond, the boiling point increases and many more property increases. In metallic bonds, we start metallic bond. A metallic conductor is a substance with an electric conductivity. The conductance means electric conductivity that decreases when increases temperature. In metallic, when we increase the temperature, electricity conductivity decreases. A semiconductor is a substance with a electric conductivity that increases with increases temperature. When we increase temperature in semiconductor, electric conductivity increases. But in metallic conductor, when we increase temperature, the electricity conductivity decreases. Molecular orbital theory of small molecule can extend it to account for property of solids, which are arrangements of the almost infinite number of atoms. This approach is strangely successful for description of metals. It can be used to explain their characteristic of lusters. What is luster? Luster is the, when you cut any metal transversely, you see some springing, shining layers. You found some shining layers. That means the luster of that metal. They are good electrical and thermal conductivity. Their malleability. Malleability is the, for the metal, when you give the temperature, it melts. And thermal conductivity, a good electrical conductivity, you see. Metal wire is used for the conductor of electricity. All these properties arises from ability of atom to contribute electron to a common sea. The concept is there is a common sea where electron is there and electron moves to give the conductance of that electricity. The luster electrical conductivities stem from the mobility of these electrons in response to either oscillating electric field of an incident ray of light to potential difference. The high thermal conductivity is also consequence of electron mobility because electron can collide with vibrating atoms. Electron collide with vibrating atoms, pick up its energy and transfer it to another atom elsewhere in the solid, and then conductivity takes place. The ease with which metals can mechanically deformed, that means when we put the hammer to any metal, another aspects of the electron mobility, because the electron C can quickly readjust to deformation the solid and continue bind the atom together. Electric conduction is also a characteristic of semiconductor. Conductor and semiconductor, we see difference is there on in the first slide. The criteria for the distinguish between metallic conductor and the semiconductor is temperature dependent of the electric conductivity. Temperature dependent, that means metallic conductor, when temperature increases, conductivity decreases. Whereas in semiconductor, temperature increases, the electric conductivity also increases. Properties of metals. A single property that best distinguishes metal from non-metals is conductivity. Non-metals are non-conductive, metals are conductive. That the main difference between metal and non-metals. Metals have high conductivity, low resistance to the passage of electricity and of heat. Okay, non-metal have low conductivity, high resistance. One exception is diamond, which has low electrical conductivity, high heat conductivity too. Conductivity is discussed the electronic structure of metals and semiconductor. Aside from conductivity, metal have quite varied properties. Some of the soft and easily deformed by pressure, impact, malleable, like copper, its FCC structure, whereas other hard and brittle, more likely to break rather than bend, is zinc. It is HCP structure, hexagonal structure. However, most can shaped by hammering or bending. This is possible because bonding of non-directional, each atom is rather weakly bonded to all neighboring atoms rather than the individual atom, as is the case in discrete molecules. Okay, these are the characteristics of metal. Metallic conductor is substance with a electric conductivity that decreases with increasing temperature. We all discussed about it earlier. And in semiconductor is a substance in a electric conductivity that increases with increasing temperature. And some we study, there are some superconductor also. What are superconductors? Superconductors are a special class of material, have zero electrical resistance. There is no resistance below the critical temperature. At critical temperature, their resistance is zero and they are much conductor. See, this is the graph. The conductivity and temperature after the variation of temperature, how conductivity, this is the unit of conductivity, Simon per centimeter. And when we see metal, this is the conductivity. When we increase the temperature, conductivity decreases. This metal, this to this, the conductivity decreases, increasing of temperature. And in semiconductor, we see from this to this, the like this, this may be this, from this to this, conductivity increases on increasing of temperature. And in superconductor, we see at low temperature, conductivity is high, and when increasing of temperature, and this is the critical point. From here to here, it is much conductivity at low temperature. This is the critical temperature of that superconductor. And then further increasing of temperature, the conductivity decreases. That's why electrical conductivity of the substance with temperature on the basis of classification of substance as metallic conductor and semiconductor and superconductor. Yes, metal conductivity or band model of solid is extension of the molecular orbital method. Overlap the atomic orbital in the extension of solid give rise the continuous bands of electronic energy level associated with the difference degree of bonding. In a simple monoatomic solid, the bottom of the band is made up of orbital bonding between all neighboring atom orbits at the top of the bond or antibonding, and label in the middle have intermediate bonding character. This is the characteristic of band model of the metal. Difference between the orbital can principle give rise the difference band, although they have overlap in energy. Fundamental distinguish between metal and non-metallic solid. This is the fundamental difference of metal and non-metal solids. Metallic behavior results from the band particularly occupied by electrons, so that there are no energy gap between top level known as Fermi level and the lowest empty one. The other hand, non-metallic solid have band gap between completely filled band, valence band and the completely empty conduction band. In the field of band, motion of any electron is matched by another one moving in the opposite direction, so that there is no net motion of electric charge. For conduction to occur in the non-metallic solid, therefore, the electron must excited from valence band to conduction band. This gives rise activation energy and conductivity increases. The rise in the temperature approximate in the accordance with the Arrhenius equation used in chemical kinetics. See, non-metallic solid include ionic covalent compounds. In the formal cases, valence band is made up of top filled anion label, example 3p orbital of chlorine, which are filled making the ion, and conduction band of the lowest empty cation label of sodium is C3s label from which electron can remove to make the cation. In the covalent, it is the valence bond where electron filled electrons and they move to the conduction band. If this is empty, when this conduction band and valence band are overlapped, it is called Fermi label. This picture shows A is for non-metal, it is the metallic solid electronic label shown in shade. What is band gap? Band gap of non-metallic solid is important for electrical optical properties. Solid is a small band gap in semiconductor. The band gap is less with the conductivity, unlike case with the metal. Increase as temperature is raised. The band gap is also determined minimum proton energy required to excite an electron from valence band to conduction band. Valence band to conduction band, hence the threshold optical absorption by the solid. And what is Fermi level? Fermi level is the highest occupied energy level in a solid at temperature T0. Electron occupied individual molecular orbital of a band accordance with the building a principle. If each of the supply of 1s electron, then the lowest half n orbital is occupied. Highest occupied orbital is T0 is called Fermi level. It is lying near the center of the band. When the band is not completely filled, the electron close to the Fermi level can easily be promoted to near empty level. As the result, the mobile or move relatively free through the solid and substance is electric conductor. This is the band gap. This is the empty band. This is occupied level. This is Fermi level. The solid is packed metallic conductor. We have that certain of metallic conductor is also decreases. The electrical conductivity increased temperature is the behavior of the opposite of the what we might expect it. Conductivity were governed by the thermal promotion of the electron. More the Fermi level, the competition effect can be identified once recognized the ability of electron travel smoothly through the solid in the conduction band depend on the uniformly arrangement of the atom. An atom vibrating vigorously is a site of equivalent of the impurity that disturb the orderliness of the orbital. This decreases in the uniformly reduced ability of electron to travel from one's edge of the solid to another. So conductivity of solid is less than at T0 if we think the electron as moving through the solid, then we would say that was scattered by the atomic vibration. This carries scattering increases with increasing temperature as the lattice vibration increases. And the increase account the observation inverse temperature depend of the conductivity of metals. Here diamond, this is the band gap, the maximum band gap. Silicon carbide is 3, silicon is 1.1, germanium, silicon and germanium, and gallium, selenium, and indium or ruthenium. These are the semiconductor. What are semiconductor? The characteristic physically property semiconductor, that is electrical conductivity, increases with increase of temperature. At room temperature, conductivity of semiconductor is typically intermediate between those of metal and insulator. The dividing between insulating and semiconductor is matter of size of band gap. The conductivity itself is unreliable criteria, because as temperature increases, a give rise substance may have in succession a low, intermediate or high conductivity. The value of band gap conductivity that are taken as indicating semiconductor rather that insulation depend on the application being considered. There are two types of semiconductor, intrinsic and extrinsic. In intrinsic semiconductor, the band gap is so small that energy of thermal motion result from electron of valence bond the empty upper band. The occupation of the conduction band introduce positive holes equivalent to access the electron into the lower band. The result of solid is conduction, because the holes and promotes electron can move. Here hole moves and electron also moves. And in semiconductor at room temperature generally has low conductivity than metallic conductor, because they are very few electron hole can act as charge carriers. In extrinsic semiconductor, p-type semiconductor are solid doped with atom remove electrons from the valence band, and n-type semiconductor are solid doped with atom supply electron to the conduction band. Extrinsic semiconductor is a substance that semiconductor on account the presence of intentionally added impurities. The number of electron carrier can increased with atom or more electron than the parent element can be introduced by the process called doping. This is the graph. Here the band structure of n-type semiconductor or p-type semiconductor. It is the extrinsic semiconductor. Here it is the donor, it is the S band, this is P band. Here the electron moves like that. And this one is the energy label. A is the insulator. The band gap is this. No conduction takes place with the filled band gap, and metal is the partially filled. In this it is for metals and separated band, and metal overlap with this overlapping band. This is for metals. This is the summary of the module. From the above unit, you can come to know about types of bonds, their properties, many type of atom combined to the other or same atoms, and what extent they may combine with other atom. You also learn that types of bonding takes place between atoms and how extent the theory is applicable in the formation of molecule. also learned the type of bonds as ionic, covalent, coordinate, metallic and non-metallic, etc. These are the some suggested books, and thank you. If you have any questions, you can mail us in this mail ID, and my contact number is given here for you. Thank you for your kind attention.